doing? For 10 hours each day.
Thank you, Mike.
Paul Tucker stands outside a supermarket as shoppers pass by. He's a soft-spoken, friendly man with a red kettle, helping the Salvation Army. Ask him why.
They've helped me out a lot, too. You know, there's been days where I didn't have nothing to eat, and they were there for me.
Like other volunteers, he gets $20 a day, at night returning to the Good Samaritan Haven, the local homeless shelter. But this week, he got an eviction letter. The shelter said it no longer supports those who volunteer for the Salvation Army.
It's an outrage. I mean, this gentleman is over there. He's working what he can do.
I thought it was kind of sad, especially at this time of year. It always seems compounded.
The story is spreading across central Vermont, and many are angry.
A few weeks before Christmas. I mean, how lame is that?
Yeah, I'm disgusted.
Because?
Well, because here's a person trying to do good work, and he's not making much money doing it, but he's doing good work for the community. He's trying to help other people, and he's getting booted out.
The shelter did not respond to our visit or phone call, but requires clients work toward finding permanent housing.
The Good Samaritan Haven says it welcomes all at our door with hospitality not available elsewhere. More than half the people here find their own housing. Average stay, 29 days. Paul's been here 9 months.
Then I guess my sympathies lie with the shelter in this particular instance, unfortunately.
And Paul agrees he stayed a long time. And yet...
Where would you be without people like Paul manning the kettles?
We would have no one there to collect. If no one's there to collect, then we would be out that income. Without that income, we're not able to run year-round.
Come Saturday, Paul isn't sure where he'll sleep.
What are you going to do for Christmas, Paul?
I have no idea.
In Barrie, Stuart Ledbetter, News Channel 5.